Well, good day to you. We seem to have things working a little bit, so we're going to just ramble for our first one back, because why not? Well, today we're going to go a little bit on about, you know, hate speech and free speech. And, well, I don't care if I offend people, because, well, what the hell can you do that isn't going to offend people these days? So, where to begin? Well, as far as I know, the only country that actually has any kind of, legislation that protects free speech is the United States, which means anywhere else in the world, it can be illegal to actually say certain things or certain phrases to certain people at any given time. And we're seeing lots of signs of this where things are getting very much out of hand and very not good. So what about hate speech? Well, in Canada, we do actually have hate speech laws. And those laws are, if you say something that incites violence or hatred towards a group, hate speech. So, what does that mean? Well, for example, anybody who's promoting, say, punching a Nazi, well, hate speech, right? Because you're promoting violence. You're saying, go out and commit violence against this group. Technically, even under that law, you can't hate them. Double-edged sword, isn't it? So, you have to think about that. You know, are people actually going out and saying that, you know, we should hate these groups and we should do violence against these groups? Or are people going out and saying, we disagree with these groups, we disagree with these points, we disagree with these perspectives? And that's where you kind of get into the gray area, I guess. People just don't seem to grasp the concept that you should be able to discuss any topic. However, there's certain ways you must conduct yourselves. And this brings me to another point. Have you heard of verbal assault? That's a thing, believe it or not. The way you conduct yourself in real life should be the same as the way you conduct yourself online. Once upon a time, there was a separation between real life and online, but that doesn't exist anymore. Generations are being brought up online. So you have to understand that they are now one and the same due to social media. So how you conduct yourself online should be exactly how you conduct yourself in real life. And that is what people seem to not be able to grasp. You know, you can't quite grasp that concept. And it's very peculiar. Because, I get the sense that you would not say the majority of these things to somebody's face. Because, well, you would get a very negative reaction. And that is kind of what people are going for. I don't know. I don't know why. You know, they want to piss people off. They want to upset people. And that's not free speech. That's never actually been protected. A good example is, let's say you walk into a business. Let's say you're upset at that business and you start spewing all sorts of profanity. And, you know, you've seen videos where people lose their shit. You know what I mean? We've seen those videos. There's plenty of examples of that. I don't really need to get too deep into that. So having said that, that's verbal abuse. Right? You can't walk up to somebody and start shouting at them and spewing whatever you want at them, because they can call the police and you'll get in trouble. I mean, in the case of a business, you'll be kicked out, right? Undeniably, you can't do that in a public place. And online, social media is essentially a public place. And I don't know why this is hard to grasp. I get it with the younger kids. You know, they don't understand the separation. They weren't raised the way that my generation was, where you're supposed to conduct yourself, you know, accordingly. Like, it's mind-boggling, isn't it? Like, people think that free speech is being able to say whatever you want, whenever you want, and it's not. Like, that's, you know, you're not entitled to be an asshole. You don't have the right to be an asshole. Yeah, I get people want to be an asshole, and they're self-proclaimed assholes, or in the case of women, they're self-proclaimed bitches, and that's their excuse. Oh, well, you know, I'm just a bitch. It's like, well, that's not an excuse. that's a shitty excuse, really. That's a terrible reason. Like, who wants to be an asshole? Who wants to be a bitch? Like, I don't get that mentality. Maybe it's just because I'm Canadian. And getting back to that, you know, in Canada, yes, we have actual hate speech laws that make perfect sense. Now, a lot of people out there, like, there's no such thing as hate speech, but if you're inciting violence and hatred towards a group for whatever reason, that is hate speech. And I agree with that. All right. there's no reason to go about inciting violence towards a group. There's no reason to go inciting hatred towards a group, even if that group is extremely vile. Now, all you have to do is show why it's vile. You can go attack the ideas. See, that's the thing. There's the line, is ideas and people. You can't go after people, but you can go after ideas. And that's where free speech comes into it. Should be anyways. You should have the ability to discuss any topic and not be in trouble for it. The line there where it gets really gray and fuzzy is comedy, and I completely understand that, because offense is being offensive, I guess, whatever, you know, that's subjective. Just like comedy is subjective, and I think to a degree that you should be protected as a comedian, that, you know, you should basically be able to make a joke about anything as long as it's clear that it's a joke. In the case of, like, Count Dankula, you know, making his pug do a Nazi salute, that somehow is him trying to recruit people into being a Nazi. Like, the fuck? Really? Really? Yeah. So, that's all I'm getting at. In with this little rambling, you know, like hate speech does exist. Free speech should exist everywhere. It doesn't. It's only protected in the U.S. as far as I know. They're the only ones with it in their constitution. And that's sad. I kind of wish that every country had thought of that one, you know, and left that in there and made it so that we can say essentially what we want that isn't verbal abuse. And I have to say that, like, people really, really miss that one, that there is such a thing as verbal abuse. You can verbally abuse somebody, like, for example, your spouse. And if you can verbally abuse your spouse, then you can verbally abuse a random stranger. The only difference between those two is how much, the level of it, how often, if you will. Random stranger, it's just, you know, it's a one-time thing, perhaps, whereas your spouse, it could be a daily thing, and it's not right. That's abuse. Can you not understand that this is actually something that exists? And you being an asshole or a bitch is you verbally abusing somebody. And that is not free speech, nor should it be free speech. It should not be protected. And you know what? Go ahead. Get pissed off at me. I don't care. That's just reality. And people these days seem to have a hard time with reality because it doesn't fit with what they want. And you know what? The world doesn't revolve around you. And even if it did, you know, even if you were the king of the world, yeah, I think those things would still kind of apply. I don't know. It's this problem with ramblings. You kind of go off on a tangent. I didn't really mean to say that. It just kind of came out. Because some people seem to act like they are king shit and their egos get the better of them. And they think that they could do whatever they want. They could say whatever they want because they're famous enough for, you know, and that somehow offers them protection. And it does. Let's say social media, for example. If you were to go on there and let's say that I were to try to call out somebody who is much larger than myself by saying that, you know, hey, you know whether it's you're actually being offensive, whether you're, you know, not as intelligent as you are, maybe whatever the case may be, I'm one person. And you'll have all their fans, or at least a portion of their fans, will come in and defend them and say, well, you know, you're wrong. And they are this thing that we think they are. And that is where the issue comes in. Because, you know, when you've got a dozen to 100 to 1,000 people telling you that, no, you're wrong, that this person is, you know, free to do this, it gets in that person's head. And that's where, you know, you become really narcissistic and you get this huge ego when you think that it is appropriate to be a complete asshole all the time. And I disagree. You know, you have no right to be an asshole. You have no right to be a bitch. And yeah, I guess that's it pretty much, you know. I guess I'm rambling a little much more than I anticipated. I had thought this out a lot better than I had, but that's kind of the perk about doing it in this format, is I can just go at it. Well, thank you all for sitting with me, sitting through this, and if you have some comments, maybe we can have a discussion down below, and maybe perhaps I can make a better formatted video with this. I'm still trying to work out all the kinks and everything in this, and Oh, that last Windows update really buggered things for me, and I apologize for the poor quality of this video because, well, there's not a whole lot I could do. I mean, I want to make a video, I'm sick of having to do face videos, and I got this working just enough that I can do this. So, thank you all. Big bear hugs. I love all you guys. You guys are the best. I hope you have a great day. Cheers.